corner. You know why this is important? Because the way ideology functions today, it's not so much that, let's not be naive, that people didn't know about it. But I think the way those in power manipulated, yes, we all know dirty things are being done, but you are being informed about this obliquely in such a way that basically you are able to ignore it. And can I make a terrible, maybe sexual offensive, but not dirty, don't be afraid. A husband, sorry for being chauvinist, which a husband may know abstractly my wife is cheating on me. And you can accept, okay, I'm a modern, tolerant husband, but you know, when you get the photo of your wife doing things, it's quite a different thing. I would say, with all respect, something, it's very important, because the same, no, I'm not living here, the same thing I remember happened, I think, about 2 years ago in Serbia. You know, people rationally accept that we did horrible things in Srebrenica and so on, but you know, it was just abstract knowledge. Then, by chance, all the honor to Serb media who published this, they got hold of a video effectively showing a group of Serbs pushing to an edge and shooting a couple of Bosnian prisoners. And the effect was a total shock, national shock, although, again, strictly seeing nobody learn anything new. So here, so that I don't get lost, if you allow me just a little bit more, here we should see the significance of WikiLeaks. Many of my friends who are skeptical about it are telling me, so what did we really learn? Isn't it clear that every power, in order to function, you have collateral damage, you have to have a certain discretion, what you say, what you don't say. But to conclude, I will propose a formula of what WikiLeaks is doing, and it's extremely important. Of course, I'm not a utopian. Neither me nor Julian believes in this kind of a pseudo-radical openness. Everything should be clear and so on. But what are we dealing with here? Another example from cinema, very short, Ernst Lubitsch Ninochka. You find there a wonderful joke where, I think towards the beginning of the film, the hero enters a cafeteria and says, can I get some coffee with cream, please? And the waiter answers him, sorry, we run out of cream, we only have milk, so can I serve you with coffee without milk? That's the trick here. Like, when we learn something from the media, if I may reply, repeat the metaphor, they behave as if they are serving coffee with cream. That is to say, of course, we all know they are not telling the entire truth. But you know, that's the trick of ideology. Even if they don't lie directly, the implications, the unsaid is a lie. And you bring this out. You are not so much putting them, catching them as they put it with their pants down, lying on behalf of what they explicitly say, but precisely on behalf of what they are implying. And I think this is an absolutely crucial mechanism in ideology. It doesn't only matter what you say, it matters what you imply to say and so on. So, just to make the last point, I think that are we aware at what an important moment we are living today? On the one hand, as you said, information is crucial and so on. We all know that it's crucial even economically. I claim that one of maybe the main reasons capitalism will get into crisis is intellectual property. In the long term, it simply cannot deal with it. But what I'm saying is just take the phenomenon that media are trying to get us enthusiastic for. Clouds, like, you know, computers getting smaller and smaller and all is done for you up there in a cloud. Okay, but the problem is that clouds are not up there in clouds. They are controlled and so on. For example, you rely on, maybe you have an iPhone, but you mentioned Murdoch, no, was mentioned here. Do you know, it's good to know if you rely on your news through iPhone or whatever, that Apple signed an exclusive agreement with Murdoch Murdoch's corporation is again the exclusive provider of entire news and so on and so on. This is the danger today. It's no longer this clear distinction, private space, public space. The public space itself gets, as it were, privatized in a whole series of invisible ways, like the model of it being clouds. Which is why, and again, this involves new modes of censorship. I repeat this. That's why you shouldn't be tricked when you say, but what really did we learn new? Maybe we learned nothing new, but you know, it's the same as in that beautiful old Andersen's fairy tale, the emperor is naked. The emperor is naked. We may all know that the emperor is naked, but the moment somebody publicly says the emperor is naked, everything changes. This is why, even if we learn nothing new, but we did learn many new things, but even if nothing new, the forum matters. So don't confuse Julian and his gang, in a good sense, not the way they are using it. Don't confuse them with this usual bourgeois heroism, fight, investigative journalism, free flow, and so on. You are doing something much more radical. That's why it aroused such an explosion of resentment. You are not only violating the rules, disclosing secrets, and so on. Let me call it in the old Marxist way, the bourgeois press today has its own way to be transgressive. Its ideology not only controls what you say, but even how you can violate what you are allowed to say. You are not just violating the rules. You are changing the very rules how we were allowed to violate the rules. This is maybe the most important thing.